Hi, I'm Dr. James Machino. What is hormone replacement therapy, or HRT? Well, you know, at menopause, this is the point in a woman's life when her monthly cycles come to an end, as you likely know. And then there's symptoms that occur as a result. There's, you know, hot flashes, night sweats, insomnia, you can have a racing heart rate, a whole bunch of other changes. And one of the treatments, of course, is hormone replacement therapy, which I'm going to explain shortly. The question is, you know, why does menopause occur in the first place? Well, normally at the end of a menstrual cycle, estrogen and progesterone levels are very low. And there's a gland in the brain that picks up on that message. It's called the hypothalamus. And it basically sends releasing factors down to another gland in the brain called the pituitary gland. Then the pituitary secretes hormones that go down to the ovaries to start another menstrual cycle. Those hormones are called FSH and LH, follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. So as those hormones go through the bloodstream and they tell the immature egg follicles in the ovaries to start maturing and ripening, and then around day 14, one of them outpaces the rest and sort of pops out into the fallopian tube, and we call that ovulation. So while that egg follicle is developing in the ovaries, it's producing estrogen. While it's rolling down the fallopian tube, it's also producing estrogen. And the part that gets left behind in the ovary is called the corpus luteum. It secretes progesterone primarily in the second half of the menstrual cycle. Now, if the egg doesn't get fertilized by a sperm at some point, it's going to dry up and shrivel up, and it can't produce estrogen anymore, so estrogen levels will fall down. And then the corpus luteum in the ovary will sort of shrivel up, and it'll stop producing progesterone, and the levels will drop really low. The endometrium will slough off. You'll have menstruation, and estrogen and progesterone levels are really low. The brain will pick up on that message and say to the ovaries, okay, girls, let's do it again next month, so the cycle starts again. So what happens at menopause? Do you run out of egg follicles in your ovaries? No, there's still about 10,000 of them there. But these are the least responsive egg follicles. Since the time a woman was 13 or 14 years old, they've had a chance to respond to those hormones. They're still sitting there going, I don't know what to do. So these are the least responsive or the least intelligent eggs, it would appear, that you have left. And so the brain knows the eggs are in there, so it starts to bombard the ovaries with all these hormones, FSH and LH, even adrenaline gets into the act, and that's where all the symptoms come from. So the medical thinking has been, let's give women estrogen and progesterone back in order to compensate for this. If there's estrogen and progesterone in the bloodstream, then the brain's not going to bombard the ovaries anymore. And so that was the thinking behind hormone replacement therapy. The problem is that they use these dangerous types of estrogens, these what are called conjugated equine estrogen that came from estrogen from the urine of horses or mares. That's like the drug, Premarin means pregnant mare's urine. And they use synthetic progesterone as well, which is not nearly as safe as using natural progesterone. Now, in fairness, those things worked to prevent osteoporosis. But because the estrogens cause cells to divide too quickly, and because it causes blood to thicken up, what you had was an increased risk of breast cancer and also vascular disease. Now, in the year 2002, that came to the forefront. The Women's Health Initiative study and also the study out of the UK called the Million Women Study both showed that women who were using hormone replacement therapy in the traditional way that it was being used, that breast cancer rates were 26% higher, that heart attack rates were 29% higher, and there was a 41% increased risk in stroke. Now, that evidence had been mounting for years before that, and I had been warning my own female patients about it, and yet doctors were still prescribing and recommending it. So the thing is that hormone replacement therapy used this way, you know, has certain critical risks that are attached to it that, really concern me to a very large degree. And so it's not the thing that I really want women to do. But that's how it works. A lot of doctors now use bioidentical hormones. I think the estrogens in bioidentical hormones may be just as dangerous as the synthetic ones that we talked about earlier, or the ones from horses, if you will. The jury is still out on this. So from my perspective, I like women to use natural herbal agents that have been proven in head-to-head studies against hormone replacement therapy to do the same thing, to reduce the symptoms of menopause, but without the risk of having these very adverse side effects. And so there are clinical studies that show that. I put all this together for you. in an ebook called The Natural Management of Menopause that I'd like you to download right now. Read it through. You'll see all the scientific references are there, because 80% of women can have total relief of menopausal symptoms without using any of those drugs. If it doesn't quite do the job, you could add natural progesterone. Talk to your doctor about that. But that's the first thing you ought to do when you're going through menopause, instead of hormone replacement therapy, in my view. So you should download that ebook right now, The Natural Management of Menopause. Every woman should see it. Most medical doctors don't study nutrition and natural medicine in school to any appreciable degree, so they're not even aware of the value of what it is. But it's all there in the scientific papers that they should be actually looking at every month, as I do, to be quite honest with you. Now, at machinohealth.com, you'll see my other research review papers, which might be of interest to you, as well as other videos I've created, footage from my live professional educational seminars, other resources and downloads that I've created, all of which are there to help you lead a long, healthy, functional life. All my research papers and teaching materials have all the scientific references there, so you'll see the information's coming from only sound, evidence-based research. So you'll know you're on really solid footing for any health or wellness information that you're looking for, any topic that you're searching for. You'll know you're getting information that's based on real research, not something that someone dreamed up. So you really should make machinohealth.com an ongoing, reliable resource when it comes to health and wellness information for both you and your family members. Thanks so much for watching.